continue straight from previous last video where we found the depth of the slab ds equal to 150 millimeters. Now we assume the depth ds equal to 170 millimeters. If I can take you back to the start of the examples where we assume the trial depth 170 millimeters. Now this 170 millimeters, we need to make sure that our minimum depth ds, that's we calculated 150 millimeters, should be less than our assumed depth. If it is not less than, then in that case we need to do the process again, repeat the process again. So we always make sure that this calculated 150 millimeters should be less than this 170 millimeters. Okay, so that assumptions that we make is correct. Now, as you know, we done the calculation on 170 millimeters, but now our depth is 150 millimeters. So we need to calculate this effective depth again, and that is the dx. I will explain you that dx in a minute. What is this dx stand for? But you can see that 150 is the total depth. Take away 25, take away 12, divide by 2. That will give me 119 millimeters. Now, for the ds equal to 150 millimeter thick slab, the permanent dead load, so if you remember that we calculate the permanent dead load was 4.7 kilopascals. In our previous example, we calculated 4.7 kilopascals, but that was based on 170 millimeter depth. Now that 170 millimeter depth, which is the weight of the slab, would be smaller because our depth is now 150 millimeters. So we can again calculate the weight of the slab, which is 0.15 times 25. 25 is the density of the concrete given in our questions, 25 kilonewton per meter, plus 1.5 times 3, sorry, not here, be here, 0.15 times 25 plus 0.5, 0.5 is coming from the 0.5 is coming from our questions where you have allowable 0.5 kilopascal is to be made for partitions. So that is a 0.5, so 4.3 kilopascal. So please note, we are not using this 4.7 kilopascal was the dead load due to the weight of 170 millimeter thick slab. Now our slab is 150 millimeter, so we remove 20 millimeter of the concrete, so it will reduce the weight, which is the dead load 4.3 kilopascals. Now if I want to calculate the factored load or design load, which is 1.2 times dead load plus 1.5 times live load, where is coming from? If you go back all the way to AS1170 on that clause on page number 15, clause 4.2.2, for permanent and imposed actions you have 1.2 g, g is your dead load plus 1.5 q, and 1.2 and 1.5 are the load factors. We are designing for the safety and for the strength, so we are just increased our load. That's load at 1.2 times 4.3 plus 1.5 times live load. Live load given in our questions, I think if I can find that live load given in the questions, imposed live load is 3 kilopascals. I substitute that value, give me 9.6 kilopascals. Now consider 1 meter wide strip in each direction which has a W star, which is the uniformly distributed load of 9.6 kilonewton per meter. So what they are talking about, that we need to get the 1 meter wide strip along this length, and on that length you have these you can also consider the 1 meter wide strip along this length, and that also along this length you have 9.6 kilonewton meters. Now once I need to calculate the reinforcement, what is the area of reinforcement in this 1 meter strip wide strip, and we also need to know the spacing between that reinforcement. So I just need to discuss the detailing of the reinforcement. The standard has given you this 9.1.3.4 figures where you can use this detailing of the reinforcement, and on other page you can see these are for one-way slabs. If you are talking about one-way slab, that is the detailing of one-way slab, and these are the detailing for two-way slabs. Now I draw this figure here just little bit on magnify view. Based on our examples, we are working on this slab, so we need to provide the detailing on these slabs. Couple of informations that I like to obtain, 5.5 millimeters, that is 5.5 meters, sorry, that is coming from here, and 7.5 meters coming from here. Now in these examples, if I make the cross sections here and if I look this side, then I need to provide the, let's say I need to provide the reinforcement along this one. So I need to provide the reinforcement along this one. That's shown here. This black line, solid black line is shown that these are the reinforcement. And this reinforcement called primary reinforcement. Okay, let's say at the mid spans, I need to provide the reinforcement along this one. I don't know what, how many spacing, what is the spacing and what's the area that I want in the 1 meter strip, but that is called primary reinforcement. And along these directions, I also need to provide that, that is a top one, that is a secondary one. So how do we know which is the primary one? So along the length, which is 7.5 meters, you can see then it is your primary reinforcement. So if you are taking the, let's say if I can draw it up here, if you are taking, let's say this 1 meter wide strip on this one. So along this longer length, which is let's say 7.5 meters. So you can provide this along this one, that would be the bottom one. So that is it, the bottom, it is 7.5. And let's say take 5.5 meters here, and at the top, you will provide the secondary reinforcement. So these are the top bottom reinforcement, that is shown here, that is bottom reinforcement, and that is the top reinforcement that I saw here. So bottom reinforcement, which is the primary reinforcement, that will span along the along this length, 7.5 longer lengths, and these are along the shorter lengths, it's called secondary reinforcement. Now it's shown here. Now this length should be extended a little bit up to here. Let's say this length will be 50 millimeters on the east side, so you can extend that. All the detailings are given here. Some are not exactly the one, but some of them are based on development length and all, but I encourage students to go through these figures here. This one here at the supports, we need to provide the reinforcement at the top. So at the supports, you have top reinforcement. Please note, this is your primary reinforcement, and you have this reinforcement, which is secondary reinforcement. We just have this primary reinforcement on the top, and there is a secondary reinforcement. Again, from this support face, you need to have extended this reinforcement up to 0.3 ln, and ln is basically from here to here. The distance from this support to this support face is 5.5, because you are taking 0.25 taking away, so that will give you 500. So you can just 0.3 times 5 meters will give me 150 millimeters. So you need to extend that bar out of that supports. You can provide the standard cog here for that development length that we discussed in the previous videos. If I take the cross sections along these ones, I can see this spacing. So if I just redraw here, I have these bars, which are the red one. Let me draw this red line here. So I have this red line going along this side. That is your primary ones, though that you can see the red one. So over here, these are the red ones. Okay, so that's the bottom one, the red ones. Now, if I just redraw this another one, which is let's say the blue one, that blue one, these are the primary one, the red one. And let's say the blue one, I can draw it up here. That blue one that is can be seen here, if you are looking from this side, these are the blue one, that are the secondary one, along the along this, and this is the blue one. Okay. Similarly, at the supports, you can have this reinforcement at the bottom. So that is your primary reinforcement, and you will have same thing like here, standard cog here. Cog details we discuss in the development length video, and then you have this extended length, which is 0.3 ln. Again, here from the supports, you can extend 0.3 ln and continuous. So I think that's the detailing of the reinforcement, very important, and we will continue. So now my intention first is to calculate this spacing, the spacing between this red one. What is the spacing from here? Is 100 millimeter, 200 millimeter, 300, 500, 600? What is the spacing that we need to calculate? So we need to know what is the spacing here at the mid span, and what is the spacing here at the supports. That is in the next video. Okay, that is in the primary directions that we like to calculate first. Let's work it out in the next video. What is that reinforcement requirement along this primary reinforcement? And please note, primary meaning that along this length longer, but parallel to this shorter span. Thank you very much.